Do you feel a sense of closure at all? I mean, because it's very, your story is very different from the sewer bike families, because they've been going through this for years. It's still sort of fresh for you. How do you take this?
Yeah. It's a, maybe it's not closure, maybe it's a chapter. Because at some point, we'll get to look at case files, evidence, hopefully get on the property. You know, and I'm sure we'll get a lot of answers when we start looking at, you know, where the phone's pinged, you know, different things of that nature.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And you, what would it mean for you to be able to get up the property? You know, you've mentioned that to me a couple of times now.
I just want to see, you know, to get, I guess to be able to, I don't know, it's weird, but, you know, see where my son spent his last day, and...
Was it, how did you handle seeing Colhead in court in the same building, in the same room with him? I guess this is the second time.
I was actually... When I was giving my impact statement and I was standing in front of the judge, I could see him out of the corner of my eye. And there was just no remorse. I mean, no emotion. It was just like a body standing up there with no soul. That was my thing.
Yeah. Do you think that there's other victims out there? I mean, no, his attorney said no, but it seems that everyone else seems to be otherwise.
I do. Yeah, I just think it's hard to go from 2003 to 2015 and not have done something.
Do you expect some of that to come out, or as far as Colhead going forward, I mean, he's going to be in prison the rest of his life. Do you think he'll just kind of stay there quietly, or do you think he might try to get back in the limelight?
I don't know, you know, I thought of that earlier. I was like, you know, what does he do for me? You know, he has nothing to lose other than giving people closure if he did do something. You know, I mean.
And as far as, you know, your son, do you feel like, you know, he's here in some way, or able to see the events that came down today. You know, how do you sort of like handle him not being here now?
I feel like he's smiling. You know, that was his thing. I think he's just smiling down on his witness that we did the right thing.
Let's do that. Come on.
Anything else wrong with that?
Just thank you to you guys for covering it.
Yeah, well, thank you for being so welcoming and just letting your story be told. I mean, I don't know, if I put myself in your shoes, I don't know who I'd want to talk to or if I'd be okay talking to anybody, but
yeah.
You seem to be handling it pretty well. Your whole family seems very strong through that whole, this whole mess.
Well, we just have to lean on our faith and know that God is in control, and in the end, he'll reign supreme.
Absolutely. Thank you so much. I'm sure you're hungry.